In this video, we're going to talk about the linear algebra of rotations in three dimensions, in particular the group SO3 of rotations and the Lie algebra little SO3. So first we need some definitions. Big SO3, capital S, capital O3, is the group of all rotations in three dimensions. The S and the O stands for special orthogonal. This is the three-dimensional special orthogonal group. Orthogonal means that they're orthogonal matrices, and special means that the determinant is plus 1 as opposed to minus 1. Little SO3 is the set of all 3x3 anti-symmetric real matrices. And this is called the Lie algebra of big SO3. This is usually written with Gothic letters. I can't draw Gothic letters, so whenever we're using the Lie algebra, I'm going to write it in red. So when you see little SO in red, that's the Lie algebra. Big SO is the group. So what the heck is a Lie algebra and what the heck is a group? Well, first of all, let's go look at the group. A group is a set of elements such that whenever you multiply two of them, they're still in the group. And whenever you take the inverse of one of them, it's still in the group. And I claim that SO3 has this property. If R and T are rotation matrices, then I claim that R inverse is a rotation matrix, and that R times T is a rotation matrix. Let's see how that works. See, we need to show to be an SO3, it has to be orthogonal, which is to say that the transpose times the matrix has to be the identity, and it needs to have a determinant of plus 1. So we need to show that R inverse has this property, and we need to show that RT has this property. So let's do R inverse first. Well, since R was an orthogonal matrix, R inverse is just R transpose. So if you take R inverse transpose times R inverse, that's R transpose transpose, in other words, R, times R transpose, and R times R transpose is already the identity because R and R transpose are inverses. And the determinant of R inverse is the determinant of R transpose, which is the determinant of R, which is 1. So far, so good. The inverse of an element of SO3 is an SO3. What about the product? Well, if you take RT transpose times RT, and I apologize for using the same letter T for transpose as for a matrix, then it's T transpose R transpose RT. That's T transpose RT. But R transpose R is the identity. So you get T transpose T, and that's also the identity, because R is in the group and T is in the group. And the determinant of RT is the determinant of R times the determinant of T, which is 1 times 1, which is 1. So we've just shown that, sure enough, I called it a Lie group. Lie means that it's a continuous group. And it really is. The product of any two rotation matrices is a rotation matrix. The inverse of any rotation matrix is a rotation matrix. Okay. The commutator of two matrices is defined to be the first times the second minus the second times the first. And this is often written in this bracket notation, square brackets. Square bracket of A and B means AB minus BA. And a Lie algebra is a set of matrices that form a vector space. You can add the matrices, you can multiply them by scalars, and such that the commutator of any two matrices in your set is also in the set. And I claim that little SO3 is in fact a Lie algebra. So let's check. They're obviously closed under under scalar multiplication and addition. But if A and B are in little SO3, remember we defined little SO3 to be the set of all anti-symmetric real matrices. So if A and B are anti-symmetric, A transpose is minus A, and B transpose is minus B. And let's take the transpose of the commutator. That's a transpose of AB minus BA, and when you take the transpose of something, you take the product of the transposes in the opposite order. So the transpose of AB is B transpose A transpose. And the transpose of BA is A transpose B transpose. But B transpose is minus B, and A transpose is minus A. So this is minus B times minus A, in other words, BA. And this is minus A times minus B, in other words, AB. So the transpose of the commutator is minus the commutator. So the commutator is anti-symmetric, which is what we want. Okay, so we've got our Lie group and our Lie algebra, and how the heck are they related? Well, I claim that if you give me an anti-symmetric matrix, that is any element of the algebra, its exponential is in the group. So here's why. If A is in the algebra, well, its dagger just means it's transpose because it's a real matrix, and that's minus A. So this means that minus A times A dagger, the conjugate of minus IA dagger, conjugate of minus I is I times A dagger, which is minus IA because A dagger is minus A. So minus IA dagger is minus IA, so minus IA is Hermitian. So if you take e to the a, that's e to the I times something Hermitian. And we saw in the last video that e to the I times a Hermitian matrix is unitary. So e to the a is unitary. But e to the a is also real because a was real. You exponentiate a real matrix. You get it by the power series if you want, and you get a real matrix. So it's real and unitary, and that makes it orthogonal. What's more, A is anti-symmetric, so it's zero on the diagonal. So its trace is zero. The determinant of the exponential is the exponential of the trace, which is e to the zero, which is one. So anytime you exponentiate an anti-symmetric matrix, you get a rotation matrix. You know, it's orthogonal. It has determinant one. Now, the eigenvalues of A, since minus IA was Hermitian, minus IA has real eigenvalues, which means that A has to have pure imaginary eigenvalues. They come in conjugate pairs. So if I theta is an eigenvalue, minus I theta is an eigenvalue, and the remaining eigenvalue has to be zero. The eigenvalues of e to the A are e to the zero, e to the I theta, and e to the minus I theta. And we saw before that you can figure out the axis and the angle of rotation from the eigenvalues and eigenvectors of a rotation matrix. The axis is the eigenvector with eigenvalue 1, and the angle is theta. So e to the a is a rotation by an angle theta about an axis, which is this eigenvector, the eigenvector with eigenvalue 1 for e to the a or 0 for a. So for example, let's look at this matrix. It's anti-symmetric, and its eigenvalues wind up being 0, I pi over 3, and minus I pi over 3. The way you can figure out what the eigenvalues are is you look at the trace of A squared. That has to be the sum of the eigenvalues squared, so that's 0 squared plus I theta squared plus minus I theta squared, so that's minus 2 theta squared. So in the trace of A squared, you can figure out what theta is. In this case, it's I pi over 3. Sorry, theta is pi over 3. And the eigenvector with eigenvalue 0 is just 1, 1, 1. You see that the sum of all the rows is 0. That if you multiply this by 1, 1, 1, you get the 0 vector. That means this must, e to the a, must be a rotation by pi over 3 about this axis. And if you work it out, it comes out to this matrix, which we've seen before. We've seen that this is a special orthogonal matrix, which is a rotation about the 1, 1 axis, 1, 1, 1 axis by pi over 3.